Good morning friends, we are going to discuss about the different kind of the solving techniques. We are going to discuss about the another important topic of the data structure, that is the different kind of the sorting techniques available in the data structure. So what actually the sorting is? The sorting is an operation that segregates the item into groups according to the structural criteria. Sorting is that we have to arrange the data in some particular order based on some criteria. It may be either ascending order or descending order. As the various example we see nowadays in our real life, that the data is arranged in some particular order, so that we are able to retrieve the information very fast, we are able to search the information very fast. That's why we arrange the data. So arranging is done based on some criteria. So that is known as a sorting over here. Then instead of giving the random data, means if you have to find some data from the random set of data, then it is very difficult for us to retrieve the data, because we have to search each and every item over there. But instead of that, if you are having our sorted data with us, then the retrieval of that information is very fast over there. So that's why we talk about the sorting. So here, if we take the original data like this, this is the random set of data. And instead of that, if we take the data in this order, this is the sorted data. So in this case, if you want to search any item, then the retrieval is much faster over here. So sorting is, we know as the ordering. And the sorted data is that the ordered data that is based on the particular field, that is arranged in some particular order. So generally we say that the collection of the data are presented in the sorted manner. The various example we can see of the sorting, that is in the dictionary, all the words as we know is in the sorted order form. You take the telephone directory, in the telephone directory, the number are arranged in the sorted order of the person name, the particular order over there. The file we see in the directory, they are then listed in the sorted order manner. The index of the book that we look at the end of this book is, that is again in the sorted order form, the particular order over here. So we are able to retrieve a particular topic from the book by going to the particular order, accessing the particular page number, and we can jump directly to that particular page. Some more examples over here, that if you are going to the bank to get our bank statement, then the bank is giving us the bank statement in the increasing order of that check number. And then this paper, we are having the calendar of the event in a schedule in the generally sorted by the date. And the musical compact disc, the CD, audio CDs, that are in the recording store, that are again stored in the ordered form of the recording artist, then the particular name over here. So what is the need of the sorting? Sorting is as I told you the example, that from the telephone directory, if you have to search a particular phone number of our friend, and if that phone number is in the random order, then it is very difficult for us. We have to go each and every tree at every page, and the time is very costly over there. So instead of that, if we take the data in the sorted order, so then it is very fast for us to retrieve the data. There are some definition, or this is some kind of sorts are there, that is the internal sorts. So data that we are sorting is stored in the computer main memory. Small amount of the data is there within the main memory, and we can sort those data. That is the internal sort. The external sort is there, that is in which the data that we have to sort are stored in some external storage media, like the hard disk, files, and all those. So on those we can perform the sorting over. That is known as the external sort. If the sort is that amount of external space required to sort the data is constant with the input size. So we perform in place over there. So there are some kind of sorting algorithms are available. There is a basic sorting we commonly use, that is a global sort, special sort, insertion sort, heap sort, merge sort, quick sort, shell sort, Redis sort, and so on. So we go through with this sorting techniques one by one. Let's start with the global sort. Global sort is the name saying that as we see the bubble in the water, that the bubble get pop up and come on the surface of the water. So how it taken place? Whenever the bubble come, as it move upwards on the surface, then when the bubble comes at upwards, the amount of the water, amount of the space that is required by that bubble, that means amount of the water is flowed downwards to occupy the space that is left by that bubble. So same thing is here, that as you move the data in some particular way, particular direction, then that space is, when the data is moved from that location to another place, then the other data will come on that place that has been on that space that has been left by the data that has been moved from that place. So in the bubble sort, the approach that is taken place is that every consecutive elements are compared with each other in the array. And if the data is not in the order, then we make them in the order. So every alternate elements are compared with each other, and we keep on comparing up to the end, starting from the first up to the end. And if the data is not in the order, then we make them in the order and place in the proper format. So in this way, the element which is at the, if we are in the two element in which the at the higher place we are having, at the higher index we are in the value less than the value available at the lower index, then we interchange the value and we bring the smaller value at the lower index and higher value at the higher index. Here we can take the example. Here we can take the example. Suppose this is some initial set of data is given to us. So we starting from the first location. First we compare 9 and 6. They are not in the order, so we make them in the order 6, 9. Then 9 and 2 is compared. They are not in the order, so we make them 2 and 9. Then 9 and 12 is compared. They are in the order. Then 12 and 11 are compared. They are not in the order, so we make them in the order 11, 12. Then 12 and 9 are compared. They are not in the order, so we make them 9, 12. Then 12 and 3 are compared, so it will become 3 and 12, and 12 and 7 are compared, so it will become 7 and 12. So by this is the first pass, this is the first iteration in which we are accessing the element from the first location up to the end of the location. So we can see here that we have got the largest element at the end of the list. So with every pass we are getting the one element get moved, highest element will move from that location to the end. So at every pass, one element is at proper position. So this is the first pass in which the elements are moved. So here every consecutive elements are compared with each other, and we keep on moving the elements. This is the first pass. So after the first pass, this is our position. 12 is at the proper position. Now the second pass. In the second pass, we compare 6 to, so it will come to 6, 6, 9, 9, 11, then it keep on comparing. So in this case, it will become like this. 6 to 12 compares, so it will become to 6. Then 6, 9 compares, so 6, 9 remain same. 9, 11 compares, it will remain the same. Then 11, 9 are compared, so it will become 9, 8, 11. 11, 3, so it will become 3, 11. 11, 7, so it will become 7, 11. So now, we got the 11 at the proper position. But in this case, now we will not compare that with the 12, because 12 is already at its proper position in the previous pass. So the number of comparison is reduced at less by 1 in from the previous step. Now the third pass. In the third pass, we compare to 6, same, 6, 9 is same, 9 and 9 is again on the same position. Then 9 and 3, we compare, so they get interchanged. 9 and 7, they get interchanged, so 7 and 9. Now in this we will not compare with the 11, because 11 is already placed at its position in the previous step. So here the number of comparison is reduced again by the 1. So in the first step we compare the 7 comparison, in the previous step 6. Now in this we are having only the 5 comparison. Now the next pass, 2, 6, 6, 9, 9, 3 interchange, 9, 7 interchange. So now we got another element at its position. Then again, fifth pass, 2, 6 compare, 6, 3 is compare, 6, 7 is compare, and so on. So here we can see that our list is already sorted, but the system does not know about this thing. It keep on continuing up to it get the number of iteration or number of passes are over. Right? So in the next pass, again it will take, it will now compare 2 and 3. 3 and 6, they are in the order. So our list now no exchange is there in between the data. So now we will say that our data is sorted. So this way bubble sort perform its operation. Take some more example. Here as I told you that at every iteration the highest element will move at its proper position. So if we take all this data initially and we form the comparisons 40 and 2 compare 2 and 1, then it will become 2 and 40. Then 40 and 1 compare, so it will become 1 and 40 and so on. So here we got the highest element 65. So in the first pass 65 will move at the end. In the second pass we will get to 58 at the end. In the third, we'll get 43 at the end. So at least one element is in the correct position at every iteration. Right? First 65 move, then 58, then 43. So we keep on moving. So one by one, all the elements will keep on moving at its proper position at every iteration. Now here, if we calculate the complexity of this algorithm, so as we have seen that initially in the first example, initially we are having the same number of comparison, then 6, then 5, then 4 and so on. At every stage number of comparison is reducing. Or you can say that initially we require n minus 1 number of comparison, then we require n minus 2, then n minus 3 and so on. And at last we require the 1 comparison. So if you have to calculate the complexity of these, it will be order of n is equals to n minus 1 plus n minus 2 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1. This is the total number of comparisons, right? So if we solve this equation, it is n into n minus 1 by 2. We can write this equation like this way. N into n minus 1 by 2. So that is equals to n square by 2 minus n by 2. Here the when the term is taking n square, so we can say complexity is order of n square, the highest complexity of any equation. So in this case, the complexity is taking means if our data is unsorted and if you have to sort that with the global sort, then we require the complexity is order of n square. That is the first case when we are saying our data is totally unsorted. But if we say that our data is sorted, in that case there is no such movement will be there, all the elements will remain in sorted order form. So the algorithm does not have to perform any kind of movement and the complexity is order of n. So this kind of the sorting is the called the original bubble sort that work only in the one direction. But if you take the bi-directional bubble sort, so that work in the back and forth in both the direction only. Here you can write the algorithm. This the order step that is I equals 0 to n minus 1, it is for the number of passes or number of iteration. And the inner loop is that here we are running from 0 to n minus I, because at every stage one element is at its proper position. So after that step, we do not need to compare with that element. So number of comparisons we keep on reducing one by one. So initially we are having n minus 1 comparison, then n minus 2, then n minus 3. So we keep on reducing. So that's why we have taken 0 to n minus I. So this for the number of comparisons, this for the number of passes. And if the elements at the j is greater than at the element at the j plus 1, so we will simply shift them. And this way we can form the algorithm for the bubble sort. Now the next algorithm we are going to discuss is about the selection sort. The selection sort, the idea is that here we are in the two group of the item, sorted group and unsorted group. In the unsorted group, initially all the elements are in the unsorted form. We assume that the item in the unsorted groups are unsorted and the item in the sorted group are the sorted form. Now we'll take the smallest or the best element from the unsorted group and then put that best element at the end of the sorted group. We are taking the two groups, unsorted and the sorted. From the unsorted one, we'll take the best in the terms we can say that if you are looking for the smallest element, so we'll take the smallest from the unsorted one and place that small segment at the end of the sorted. So by this we keep on getting the, every time we are getting the small segment from the unsorted one and placing it in the sorted one. So in the sorted one we are getting the data in the increasing order form. This process keep on repeating up to there are element in the unsorted data. As the element from the unsorted data is over, our list get sorted. So the idea is that find the smallest element in the array, exchange it with the element at the first position. We are taking the total array. Let's say for example 10 elements are there in the array. So from the array elements you find the smallest element within the complete array and find the position of that smallest element and exchange it with the first position. So we are getting the smallest element at the first position in the first iteration. In the second iteration, remaining 9 elements, again find the smallest element from the remaining 9 and exchange it with the second position. So now first and second elements are in the sorted order. Now the remaining 8 elements, that is the unsorted one, again find the smallest and place it on the third position, and this process keep on repeating up to there are elements in the unsorted data. So by this every time we keep on moving the elements in the position and we are getting finally the sorted data. So the disadvantage of the selection sort is that the running time depends only slightly on the amount of the order in the file. Although it is not that much efficient, the complexity is very high of the selection sort. Let's take an example. Initially the data is given to us like this. From this data, first find the smallest element. Let's say we find the one, the smallest. Exchange this smallest element with the first position. So we get the 1 and 8 are interchanged. So now 1 is at the proper position. Now this is the sorted, these are the unsorted. Now from the unsorted, again find the smallest. So we got the 2, the smallest. Now exchange it with the second position. So 2 is here, 2 and 4 are interchanged. So now 1 and 2 are the sorted. Now these remaining are the unsorted from 6 to 8. Again find the smallest, that is 3. Exchange it with the third position. So we are done like this. So 1, 2, 3 are now in the order. Now again take the smallest from the remaining. So that is 4. Exchange it. So 4 and 9. Now 1, 2, 3, 4 are the order. Again take the smallest. 6 is the smallest from the unsorted. Exchange it. So 6 and 9. Again take the smallest. 8. 8 and 9. So it finally our list is sorted. So this is the case. Now the 9, the single element is left, so that is at the proper position, so our list is finally sorted over here. So in this approach what we are taking, that we are taking the smallest element and interchanging it with the first position. If we take the reverse one, if we take the largest element and place it at the higher position, this reverse of this, that every time we find the largest and place it at the end of the list. Let's take this example. Here we are taking comparison data movement and sorted. Initially this data is with us. First compare the file. We are finding the largest. So 5. Compare with every elements. All the elements are compared. We find the 6 as the largest. So move the 6 at end position. So now 6 is sorted. One element is sorted. Now from the remaining are the unsorted. Now from the remaining unsorted, again find the largest. We find 5 as the largest. Again move the 5 in the proper position. So 5 is over there. So now 5 and 6 both are sorted. And the next, again find the smallest, find the largest from the remaining unsorted data. 4 is the largest. 4 is at its proper position. So now 4, 5, 6 are the sorted order. Now find the largest again. 3 is largest. 3 is at its proper position. Now again find the largest, 2 is largest, 2 is at its proper position, and this way we are done. So this way we are able to sort. Take some more example. Now in this, again we find the largest, 65. More than 65 at the end. So it will become 465, they will interchange. So we have got the largest at the end. So now this is sorted, the remaining are the unsorted. Now from the unsorted, again find the largest, 15. Move the head there. So this is sorted, this is sorted, this is unsorted. Again find the largest, 43. Move at the end. So this way, we keep on going. Then 40, interchange with the minus 1, largest. Then in the remaining 4 is the largest, so move the 4 over there. Now the remaining 3 is largest, move over there. Now 3 and so on. So this way we are able to sort the complete data. Now if you perform the analysis of this, then in this case, worst case and the best case, both are the same, order of n square. Because here the system does not know that in which order we are having the elements, at every time we need to perform the same number of comparison. Like in the first case, if you take the previous example, if you take this example, then in this we have performed n minus 1 number of comparison. In this we perform n minus 2 number of comparison. In this n minus 3 number of comparison. So as we see in the case of the power sort, then every time the number of comparisons is reducing because one element is placing at its proper position. So here the number of comparison we have got first time n minus 1, then n minus 2, then so on. Then at last we require the one comparison. Here at last one comparison is here. So if you take this, then again it is n into n minus 1 by 2, and we are getting the complexity is order of n square. So in the selection sort, worst case and the best case and average case all are same. We are getting the same complexity order of n square in all cases. But in case of the bowl sort, if the data is sorted, then the complexity is order of n. Then take the name. This is the algorithm for the selection sort. This is the algorithm for finding the smallest. The smallest from k to n, array is the array, in which data is there. The starting position is k, n is the total number of elements, and the position we are finding for the smallest. So by this we find the smallest element, and once we find the smallest, interchange the element at its proper position. So this way we can perform the selection sort. Now the insertion sort. Insertion sort is actually based on the one of the as we see in the card game when we play the card. So how the card game is placed? Play in the same way we perform the insertion sort. So in the card game, we start with the empty left hand. We don't have any card in our left, and we have the card placed on the table. Now we take one card from the table at a time and place that card in our hand at its proper position. If we take the first card we have taken in our left hand. As it is single card, so it is already in the sorted order. Now take the second card from the table. When the second card is taken, it compares with the card that is in your hand. If the second card is less than the card in your hand, so you will place it before the card in your hand. Or the second card that you have taken is greater than with the card in your hand, then you will place it after the card in your hand. So based on the position of the second card with respect to the card in your hand, you keep on placing them. Now you have the two cards in your hand. When you take the third card from the table, you compare again with the rightmost card in your hand. If it is the card that you have just taken is greater than the rightmost card in your hand, so you will place it after that. If it is less than the rightmost but greater than the leftmost, so you place it in between. Or if it is less than the rightmost and the leftmost, then you will place it before the left hand. So it can be placed before the first, between first and second, or after the second. So in place it can be there, move over there. So compare every card that is already in your, already on table with the card in your hand from right to left. The card has to be left hand are sorted. The data is the card in your hand is in the sorted order form. This card where originally the top card of the pile on the table. Okay. So this way we perform the insertion. We take the card, find the proper position, insert it. Like for example, in our hand we are having 4 cards, 6, 10, 24 and 36. Other let's say data, anything you can imagine. And now we have to insert the 12. So 12 is the another card that we have taken. So when we take the 12, first compare the 12 with the 36. As it is less than 36, move the 36 towards the right. Then compare 12 with the 24. 24 is again greater than 12. Move the 24 towards the right. Then compare 12 with the 10. Now that 12 is greater than 10. So now insert the 12 in between 10 and 24. So what we have to do that whenever we compare, we have to shift the data and find the proper position and insert the data over there. So if we say like this, that if our data is from A1 to A, J minus 1 are in the sorted order form, and we have another data AJ that is in unsorted form. We take the first element from the unsorted data. Now compare AJ with the AJ minus 1. If AJ is less than AJ minus 1, move the AJ minus 1 one position forward. Then compare AJ with the AJ minus 2, it is less than, then keep on moving. Once you find the position of AA, which is AK is less than or equals to A of J, then insert the AJ after the AK. And by this, your element will get at proper position. So this way, the insertion sort is performed. Like for example, if you are having the input data is given to us like this. So at each iteration, array is divided into the two sub-array, two parts. One part is called the sorted, another part is called the unsorted. In the sorted part, the data is in the sorted order form. In the unsorted, we are having the unsorted data here. So we take the first element from the unsorted. This first element of the unsorted is compared with the rightmost element of the sorted. If the 4 is less than 5, move the 5 one position forward. Now 4 is compared with the 2. Now we have got the element greater than this, so we insert the 4 over here. So always take the one element or the first element from the unsorted, compare it with the rightmost element of the sorted, and if the element in the sorted is greater than the element from the unsorted, then keep moving. Keep shifting towards the right. Let's take the example. Initially. So this was our original list. Here we assume that the 5 is sorted. First element is sorted and remaining are the unsorted. Okay, so we have said the 5 is sorted, remaining are the unsorted. Now take the 2. First element from the unsorted. Now compare 2 with the 5. It is less than this, so move the shift, move 5 one position forward and insert the 2 over here. Now take the 4 from the unsorted one. Compare 4 with the 5. 5 is greater than this, move 5 one position forward. Compare 4 with the 2. 4 is greater than this, so now insert 4 over here. Now take 6. 6 is compared with the 5. 6 is greater than this, so insert 6 over here. Then take the 1. 1 is compared with the 6. 6 is greater than this, move shift. 6 is shifted this. 5 is compared with the 1. 5 is shifted. 4 is compared with 1. 4 is shifted. 2 is compared with the 1. 2 is shifted. Now no more element is left, so 1 is inserted over here. Then 3 is taken. 3 is compared with the 6, so 6 is shifted. 3 compared with the 5, 5 shifted. 3 compared with the 4, 4 is shifted. Now when the 3 is compared with the 2, so we have got the position that AK is less than AJ. Means now no element is less than greater than 3. So we insert the 3 over here. So by this we got the sorted data. Here you can see. So in the insertion sort, we have the two group of the items, sorted group and unsorted group. Initially all the items in the unsorted group and the sorted group is empty. We assume that the item in the unsorted group are the unsorted form and the item in the sorted group are in the sorted form. So initially sorted group is empty, unsorted group is having all the elements. Pick any item from unsorted group, then insert the item at the right position in the sorted group to maintain the sorted property. And repeat this process until the unsorted group become empty. Here, one more example. We assume the 40 is the sorted, first element is sorted and remaining are the unsorted. Take the 2, compare with the 40, it is less than this, so insert 2 before the 40. So it's like this. 1, take the 1 from the unsorted, compare with the 40, then compare with the 2, 1 is less than 2, so insert 1 before this. And so on. Take the 43, then take the 3, so 3 is shifted and insert before the 40. Then 65 at power position, then take the 0, so 0 is compared with every element and insert it before the 1. Then take the minus 1, it compared with every element, insert it before the 0. Then 58, compared with the 65, insert it before the 65. And so on. So by this, all our elements will get sorted. Now in this, if you take the analysis of this, then the worst case order of n square, best case is order of n. The worst case is occur when our data is reverse sorted. Initially the input data will be taken in the reverse order and we have to arrange all the data in the ascending order. So in that case, we need to compare every element with all the rest of the elements at every iteration. So the complexity is order of n square. Instead of that, if we take all the data in the sorted order form, then the element is just compared one time with the single element of the sorted data. Not with all the elements, only with the single element. Rightmost element of the sorted data. So the number of comparison is equals to the number of elements. So we are claiming the complexity order of n. So worst case is occur when our element is reverse sorted. The best case occur when our element is already in the sorted order form. And another is the average case. Average case is there in which the elements are randomly ordered. So in that case we are getting complexity order of n log n. Order of n log n. This is the algorithm for the insertion sort. We are not taking the 0, we are taking 1 because 0 element we are assuming that it is already in the sorted order form. So you take the element from 1 to n, then find the element if it is less than this, so we keep on going and insert the position. So all the elements are shifted one position forward. A of j plus 1 will get the value of a of j. Then another algorithm over here, the merge sort. Merge sort algorithm is actually based on the divide and conquer approach. Divide and conquer is that in which we keep on dividing the data, means if our problem is very large, then instead of solving the large problem, better approach is that first we divide our problem into the smaller sub-problems so that we are able to solve the smaller problem very easily. Once we have got the solution for the smaller sub-problem, then we can combine the solution of all the sub-problems together and get the solution of the bigger problem. So that is the concept of the divide and conquer approach. That instead of taking the all the n set of data to solve the problems, better is that divide that n data into the small subparts. Up to it becomes so much simple that we are able to solve it very easily. Then once we have solution of the smaller data, then we can combine all of the solution together and by this way we can get the solution of the bigger problems. So the same thing is here. Like suppose the input data is given to us, so we divide this input data into two parts. So we divide into the two parts. So these are divided. Now we have to sort this data. So sorting of this data is complicated. So instead of sorting this data, we have taken two sub-items. We have taken two parts. Now we sort this two parts separately. Sort them separately. So these are the sorted data. Now merge them together. So now we merge them. So this way we got the final sorted data. So now instead of sorting this data completely, we have taken two parts. Now these two parts are sorted again recursively. Means again we are not sorting them directly. Again we are dividing them further. So we keep on dividing, and by this we got the two sorted data of this thing, and then we combine them together. So this is the merge of data. How the merging is taking place? Now look at this. Now you take that these are the two sorted parts and you have to merge them together. So every time we need to keep track of the smallest elements. That where the smallest element is there, and we are taking one auxiliary array in which we will store the data. So compare first element of both A and H. Whichever is smaller, put it over here. So A came over here, the smallest among these two. Then the smallest is moved. Now the G is the smallest over here, H is the smallest over here. Now again compare G and H. Whichever is smaller, move the in the auxiliary array. So G came over here. Now the smallest is at L, the smallest is at the H. Now compare again A and H. Whichever is smaller, H is smaller, so move H over here and there is move over here. Then A and I, they are compared. Whichever is smaller, that term over here. So I is smaller, I came over here and the smallest move over there. Then A and M are compared. Again the smallest will move over here, O and R. Then O and M are compared, M is smallest, came over here. Then O and S are compared, O came over here. Then R and S. Then R and S are compared, R is smallest. So now this array, this part, this data is over. Now we are left with the two elements. First half is full over. Now there are the still elements are left in the second half. So keep move all the elements as it is in the auxiliary array. So move S and the T as it is. And we got the final sorted data. Another example we can take. Suppose this is our data. So divide this data into the two parts. So these are the 8 elements over here. So divide it into the 4 and 4. 6, 3, 9, 1, 5, 4, 7, 2. Then 6, 3, 9, 1 is again divided into the two parts. 6, 3 and the 9, 1. These are the two parts over here. Again 6 and 3 are divided further. 6 and 3, 9 and 1. So now we have divided our elements into the so much smaller that we are left with the single elements over there. Right? In the same way 5, 4, 7, 2. So we keep on dividing. So this complete 8 set of elements are divided into the 8 different parts. Okay. Now combine them together. Merge. So merge them in the sorted order form. So now we get 3, 6, 1, 9, 4, 5, 2, 7. They are in the sorted order. Now merge them together. They are merged. So we have got one sorted data. They are merged. We have got another sorted data. Now we are given this part is sorted. This part is sorted. Merge them together in the same way. So we got the final sorted data. Here another example. Now in this we have the 6 elements over here. So divide into the two parts, 3 and 3. Now again the 3 elements over here. So divide into the two parts, 2 and 1. So these two parts, then 38, 16 are divided again further. Then merge them together. 1836 merge with the 27. So we got one sorted data. This is another sorted data. And finally merge them together. So we got this sorted data. So this is the algorithm for this. That we are taking two index variable I and j. I is running from beginning to the mid and j is running from mid plus 1 to the end. So I will keep on going up to the mid, j will keep on going up to the end, and we compare elements at the I, element at the j. If the element at the I is less than the element at the j, so we will move the element from the I to the n, auxiliary array, and increase the I. Otherwise, element at the j is less than the element at the I, so we keep get the element from the j and increase the j. So we take the element from the j and increase the j. So by this, we keep on moving in this. Once the one part is over, either the first half or the second half of the array is over, in that case, we take the rest of the element from the other part in the auxiliary array. So if I is greater than mid, means first part is over, then take the rest of the element from the second part as it is in the temporary auxiliary array. Otherwise, if the second part is over, but still I is less than mid, So in that case, take the rest of the element from the first part of the array as it is in the temporary. And by this, we keep on this. So this is the merging and this is the sorting. So in this, we take the mid part of the array, beginning and mid, we take the mid part of the array, then we apply the, again merge sort, apply the same thing, sorting on that smaller part, on the insert two part. So this from array begin to mid, this from mid plus 1 to end. So two parts there, we apply the same approach on both the parts separately, again divide it. So this approach is called recursively. Up to we got the single element, then we start merging them together. So this way we perform the sorting. So here today we have covered the four kind of sorting: bubble sort, insertion sort, selection sort, and the merge sort.